over there. You took my child.
I'm a hitman. Shut up!
Fuck you!
Ken and I are gonna watch a movie. Seriously? Hun, I thought you were done with all of this.
I know you've watched enough TV to understand that it doesn't work like that.
And here I thought that you were actually here to visit. Didn't realize you were gonna use my house as a base of operations.
I'm sorry, Em. You know you're one of the few people I trust.
What are you even doing? You know what? I don't know why I even thought to ask.
Hey, if it makes you feel any better, I'm not planning on killing anyone this time.
Then why do you have a gun in my house?
I said I'm not planning on killing anyone this time. I'm not talking about the other guy. Listen, I know this isn't what you expected. But it's a quick job. How about this? Tomorrow, you and I can go to Haven Lights.
We haven't been there since college.
Well, perfect. It's a date.
Please, be safe.
No promises.
Oh.
And him? Thank you.
Hey, it's M. Target's on the move. I expect you to keep up your end of the deal.
Hey, Johnny, how you doing? My little buddy, my big boy, my big man. Oh, look at your muscles. Have you been hitting the gym? Oh, you're gonna get your old man football player's body. Please don't end up like me.
Pop, I've been having nightmares.
Oh, well, what kind of nightmares, my son?
I start, and I'm in a cornfield, and there's corn all around me, but it's alive.
Give it a taste.
But I don't want to taste. I don't want to taste, so I run. I run, but the cornfield is never ending. And then I run into him. It's me. It's me. But I'm your age. I'm older.
Hello, John. It's me. You. We.
And then he says to me, "You can have anything you ever wanted."
You can have everything you've ever wanted.
And all you have to do is taste the corn. He says that in order to get it, all I need to do is just give it a taste. And I can feel the temptation. And I want everything I've ever wanted. But just when I'm about to give in and give it a taste, I wake up. What does it mean?
I don't.
What does it mean?
I don't know.
What does it mean, Papa?
I don't know.
What does it mean?
I don't know.
Tell me.
I don't know.
I hate you. I hate
you,
Papa.
Shut up.
What do I need, Papa?
Fudge you, shut up.
What do I need?
Maybe what you need. Some fresh pizza from Papa John's! Papa John's pizza! Better ingredients! Better pizza! Papa John's!
Thank you, Papa.
You're welcome, my son. Sneaking up on John. Sneaking up on John. I'm gonna get you! Oh, come here, you little rascal!
Hi there, geese and ganders. My name is Richard Swallows, and I'm here to say that I'm the proud owner of Scream in a Box Incorporated. That's right, down in our warehouse in Wahoo, Nebraska, you can find all of your Scream in a Box needs. Want to cure that hangover? Want to tell a landlord to fix that goddamn water heater? Wanna wake up, Grandma?
Hi there. I'm not sure this scream is right for you.
And that's fine, because with our exchange program, we can get you the scream that you're looking for. Down to the Screaming Box Incorporated and find the scream that's right for you!
I'm sorry, Mom. I should have listened. Goodbye, Mom. I could really go for pizza right now.
Oh boy, she's looking right at me. Okay, act cool. Act cool.
Where the hell is my phone?
Goodbye, Mom.
It's gonna be okay.
Ah!
Don't freak out, but I can hear your thoughts and you can hear mine.
Who are you? Why can you hear my thoughts?
I'm just here to help, and I've always been able to read minds, but that's not important. What happened?
I was walking home alone. She told me never to do that, but it happened so fast, and now I'm trapped here.
Do you know where you are?
I don't know.
He had a bag over my head when he dragged me in. I've heard him making calls, mentioning an Oak Street. I remember his car. It's a blue-gray,
Volvo.
Yes, do you know it?
It's parked right next door to me.
That's amazing. Can you call the police?
Wait, that might put you in danger. How about we try and get you out first?
But what about him? He's always around and I can't tell when he leaves because of that damn TV.
I have something for that. Just wait. Just wait. Leave now.
I made it!
Just stay calm. You're not out of the woods yet.
No. It's locked!
Try his room. It's upstairs.
He's back. I can't. Yes, you can.
Can you hear me? Hello? It's okay. What's your name?
It's Stephanie.
To nowhere. I was just going about my duties when the ship approached. Where are you, Captain, sir? We need ye. All our men keep fighting their best fights, but some be taking hits and keep running, they do. And, sir, the ship, she's sinking, Captain. Oh, they be after the secret treasure, I bet. And old Pickles got stuck in this here barrel, Captain.
Got stuck in a barrel, Captain. Tried loading a cannonball at me ball shaft, and then Brits struck me with a ball from their own.
Threw him straight into the barrel, it did, Captain.
Turned me insides and outsides, it did.
But we can help get him out, Captain.
Oh, no. It's fine. I'm kind of afraid to see what happened if you tried to take me out of this barrel. I'd be a rotten mess with what the insides be mixed in with the rum. Me blood being mixed in with the rum. The old poop deck being mixed in with the rum.
Okay, that's enough out of ye. Captain? Oh, God! Oh, it hurts! Captain? Where ye be? Doth ye be a spirit? Haunting ye own vessel after ye own death? Oh, Captain, sir, I'll take care of your secret treasure as long as ye tell me where I can find it.
No, ye fortuneless krill! I be under the blanket. No, not that one. No, not that one, you idiot!
There are a lot of blankets, don't yell at me!
I'm over here.
Oh, Captain! Thank Neptune, you're alive! I thought ye a spirit, I did. Thought ye'd gone on to the other side, I did. Oh, Captain, I came in here and I didn't see you underneath all these blankets,
no,
so I thought...
I know what happened. I was there. Here.
Well, we best be going, Captain. Lest the British try to steal our secret treasure.
All right, well, you go ahead.
And abandon me, Captain? No, siree, no, ma'am. A good swabby never abandons his captain in his time of need.
Then where was you 5 minutes ago?
Well, I was doing me duty, Captain. Swabbing me poop deck I was. Swabbing up and down I was. And then I cleaned the back of the ship when I was done. Oh no. Oh, Captain, no. You mustn't vomit from your stomach when you're on your backside like this. Allow me to aid.
No. Get off of me. Get off. Just let me lie here.
But, Captain, the British...
I will just let them come. I haven't a single gold doubloon on this lily vessel.
But the hidden treasure, Captain.
Oh, all right. Well, they won't find it. They'll just sink us instead. Oh.
I got just the thing indeed. I got just the thing for you, Captain.
Don't go in me washroom, boy. You'll find me captain's log.
Take these, Captain. Please, take them.
What are you doing with me soap, boy?
Well, I thought that when we get plunged into the ocean, Captain, well, I thought that your soap could wash us to shore. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yes.
Well, it's a joke, Captain. Do you love jokes?
No, I don't have time for jokes, you son of a bitch. My life is in shambles.
Captain, what's wrong?
She left me, Pepe. Gone. Took me heart and buried it on land.
Oh, Captain, me heart goes out to ye. I guess that goes to show that even the best pirate there be still has a soul.
No, pirate. I ain't no pirate, boy.
What do you mean, Captain?
No.
You're the best pirate a boy could look up to, ye is.
No.
And all your stories of fighting sailors and stealing their treasure. You stunned them, ye did. You gave me all a right hook, eh? With your, right hook! And ye have a treasure, and that makes ye a pirate, methinks. Captain!
I'm sorry, boy. But I'm no pirate. I just be a lollygagger, a picaroon, a scoundrel, a poopy head. My head is made of poop. I don't even got a real hook for a hand.
Oh. And he peg leg, sir!
It's also fake.
And he hidden treasure, sir?
Oh, Pepe, I'm so sorry. I've been a real stinky shrimp to you all about me treasure. There is no treasure. And that's why she left me.
Well, did she take your treasure, Captain? Come on, let's go! Let's go get it! We'll take her and we'll
say, listen here, lady. Ye give me Captain his treasure back. And that'll cure your limpness, right, Captain? No. Oh, I hate to see you limp and flaccid like ye are.
Oh, boy. She left because I tried too hard to impress her. And along the way, I bent the truth. You see, boyo, women don't like it when you lie to them.
Well, men don't like it either, Captain. What all did you lie about?
Me hook for a hand, me peg leg, me hidden treasure, me college education, all of it.
Captain, you said he was an English studies major.
I know what I said. It was faking, boy. It was faking. And in return, I got me comeuppance. Me anchor's been shafted and me poop deck's been burned.
Was there ever a hidden treasure, Captain?
Once, long ago.
Where did it go?
I spent it on me hook hand and me peg limb. Cost me an arm and leg these days.
Captain, you spent all this time lying to me and the crew about your deformities. Why couldn't you just be honest with us? Oh, no. Oh, dear.
Oh. Oh. Oh, 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 I'm blind. Oh, I'm blind.
Oh, I'm sorry, Pickles.
Oh, no, it's all right. I'm good. Really, I'm fine. Oh, ow! Oh, oh, God, it hurts! Oh, ow! Oh! No, I'm all right. I'm all right.
Why couldn't you?
Oh, ow! Oh, ouch! Oh, ouch! Oh, ouch! Oh, ouch! Oh, ouch! Oh, my body! Oh, I'm fine. I'm sorry. I'm good.
What?
Oh, it's even worse this time! Oh, why won't it end? Oh, Lord in heaven, please!
No, I'm good. I think I'm getting better, actually.
Shh, quiet.
Why couldn't you just be honest with us?
Because, boy, I can't be honest with myself. To be honest, I don't like myself very much.
Why not, Captain?
Because I have nothing to show for me life. Not a thing. See, I'd spend all my time trying to be like all those other captains. But nobody's gonna remember me. I ain't no scourge of the seven seas. I'd just be a dirty, rotten scoundrel. And my whole crew, all they want out of me is me hidden treasure. Not a single genuine friend on board. Oh, talk about how lonely I'd be, day and night. I finally thought I found someone, Pepe. But she didn't like who I'd be on the insides. She didn't listen to me stories. Or laugh at me jokes.
Well, I'll laugh at your jokes, Captain. Go on, tell a joke, let's hear it.
What's a pirate's favorite letter?
Arr! That's a good one, Cap! That's a classic, it is!
No, boy! It's the sea! It's the sea.
The sea?
See, I ain't nothing.
Oh, that's not true, Cap!
And how dost ye know?
Because I'm your friend, Cap.
Me friend?
Aye, sir. You're like me own father. Well, had me father not actually been on board and died of scurvy 2 weeks ago, you'd be all I ever had. And so what if all those other captains are, you know, better than you or scourge of the seven seas? You know what? They be bullies in me own opinion, sir. Just out to hurt people's feelings and steal their treasure. And you know what? I wouldn't want a captain like that.
Oh, Pepe. Oh, you're too good to me, boyo. I
never had a friend like you, and it's been so long.
Oh, come here. We ain't nothing but a bunch of sharks without our friends, sir.
Oh.
And I sure am glad I've got you to navigate in.
Oh, I'm glad I got you to scrub me poop deck day and night. It brings a tear to my eye.
Your eye, sir. Huh? Is your eye patch fake too?
Ah! 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 Get off! Don't look at that boy. You're giving me dry sockets.
I'm sorry, Captain.
Yeah, you better be sorry or hell.
No.
I ain't gonna yell at you. It was a mistake. It was a mistake.
Thank you, Captain. Oh, oh no, Captain. We gotta get going. Come on, let's go. Let's put our backs into it.
That's the worst part, boy.
What?
She took me back.
She took you back? Well, that's great, Captain. You know, always come back, me father always said, was before he died of scurvy 2 weeks ago. When did she do that?
No, boy. She took me back. Me spine, me vertebrae. I can't move.
Oh no, Captain, we're sinking. We got to save old Pickles. Oh no, oh, he's dead.
It's all right, Pepe. It's all right. The captain always goes down with the ship. God, what better friend than ye?
But I don't want to go down with the ship. I don't want to die, Captain. Oh no. Oh no.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the sea.
Oh no.
Yo ho, yo ho, it's the pirate's life.
Are you a big man? A bigger man needs a bigger class of vehicle. And what better, bigger vehicle for your bigger, better body than the Big Red Truck? The only truck that is equipped for your bigger, better, manlier needs. Equipped with bigger accommodations for your bigger legs, your bigger arms, and your bigger hands. And you know about those bigger hands. Big Red Truck brand Red Trucks. Because you're a bigger, better man.
All right.
lasagna. Pasta, sauce, cheese. Pasta, cheese, sauce. Pasta, grommet, cheese. Pasta, sauce, cheese. Pasta, sauce, cheese. Pasta, sauce.
Jerry, are you listening to me? All right, I'm gonna run through this one more time, and if you don't listen, it's on you.
I'm sorry, Ben. This ice cream is just so damn good.
You know something? We've been brothers our whole lives, and I've steadily watched your IQ decline to levels of incompetency.
I'm such an idiot!
Yeah, I know. Now listen, about 2 hours after close, you're gonna quietly shimmy that side door open with a crowbar, and as soon as it gets open, go straight to the right and find the Dole Whip machine.
Oh, man, Ben. Have you ever tried the Dole Whip pineapple flavor? I mean, the soft serve is just...
Focus, Jerry, focus!
Okay, I'm sorry! Okay. Okay. We were talking about the Dole Whip machine.
Yes, right underneath that is the safe, which holds exactly what we need.
Ben, I sure hate to ask a stupid question, but... what exactly is it that we're looking for?
The deed, Jerry! The deed to my house, remember? Marcia's trying to... take control of my whole frickin' life, and you know, it's if the divorce wasn't complicated enough.
Wait, we aren't doing this for the money in the safe?
Are you frickin' nuts? This is my ex-wife's business. We aren't burglars. This isn't about money.
Well, I hate to break it to you, Ben, but this seems like just a lot of work for a little piece of paper, you know?
It's not just a piece of paper, it's my home. It's my whole damned life. She's already got the car, now she wants the house too. Now, if she thinks she's smart, she thinks she's smart for moving the deed into a work safe, she's got another thing coming.
Don't you think there's an easier way to go about this? My ice cream! You're a real son of a bitch, you know that?
Yeah, I know. Now, you can get another one tomorrow when we get in there and we steal that deed. And if you ask any more stupid questions, you're gonna look like that ice cream cone.
Through my teeth.
This is what 18 grueling years of learning has brought us to. Drinking in the same bar, in the same spots, with the same drunk idiots.
Yep, and we're the same pissy college students who come here and complain about the same professors every week.
And we're the same kids who have to go out into the real world and
figure it out,
as Dr. Wilson would say.
Well, at least you don't have to worry about old grandmothers telling you their elbow hurts, and that's why she needs more Oxycontin. Oh, sweet lips, can you give me more of that stuff that makes me feel like I'm getting my hair pulled at a Jimi Hendrix concert again?
How did we get here? 1 minute, we're all sitting in freshman orientation class, making fun of that girl, Brenda, who smells like hot dog water. And the next, we're having to go out into the real world and apply for jobs and doctorate programs.
Hey, you're applying for doctorate programs. Some of us are perfectly fine working an average job, unlike you.
Yeah, some of us didn't want to cry for another 3 years, and then write a book that some college freshman will probably use to prop his phone up to while he's jerking off when his roommate isn't looking.
Ew.
Nice.
Well, I think it's great that you're going to be a doctor. So, where have you been looking at going?
Right now, it's between Northern Michigan and Plattsburgh, U.S. Stooley.
Stooley? Bro, that's halfway across the country. You can't go there.
The name of the fucking town is Stooley? Stool means poop. If that isn't an indicator of what that town is like, I don't know what is. For real, what's wrong with going up in North Mish? That's like 20 minutes from here.
It's got the best nursing program in the country. I get it's a little far away, but imagine the stuff I could accomplish there.
What the hell, man? I thought we were gonna get a place downtown and just work out there for a couple years.
Bowie, they haven't even contacted me about it yet. Calm your tits, bro.
Well, if you stay here, you don't have to worry about moving all your stuff. Plus, you'll be closer to friends and family. Yeah, and you could come here every Saturday and drink with us like you always fucking do. I mean, Leo, I get it. This place blows. And you're a big fish in a piss pot here. You need to go do big boy shit.
Thanks, Chloe, but that doesn't matter right now. Let's drink.
Well, if y'all are gonna make this awkward, I'm gonna need another pitcher.
But like, why? Didn't you take into account how I would feel, Leo?
Bowie, like I told you, they haven't even contacted.
I can't believe this. He's gonna get accepted and we'll never see him again. Maybe you're the one who needs to calm their tits, Claire Standish. Who knows what that call's about? Maybe he's in and he'll get to drink wine with other rich snots and talk about dumb doctor shit. Or maybe he's not in, and we get another 3 years of bitching.
Oh, shut up, Chloe! You don't understand any of this! Leo and I had a deal, and he thinks he can just throw this all away? I think not.
Well, guess I'm picking up my doll on the way home. I just think he'd be happier here. Somewhere with friends and family. Places familiar, you know? Harp, I love you. A lot. You sound like that bitch from Psycho. Shit, what's her name?
Norma?
Yes, you sound like Norma Bates, and Leo is your psycho killer son you slept with.
Besides how gross that comparison is, I just want what's best for him.
Oh my fuck, you wanna bang Leo in a non-mother son way?
Jesus Christ, Chloe, what the fuck?
Holy fuck, now it all makes sense. How long have you felt like this? You fucker, say what?
What? Oh, fuck you. Since we met, all right.
Okay. Okay, thank you so much. Bye.
You know what this means? You can make cute-ass babies, and I can be Aunt Chloe, and I can have them both in my arms.
What are you going on about, Chloe?
Jesus H. Bush. What was that all about?
Well, that was Stooley.
And?
And I am accepted. And they're offering me a teaching position in exchange for tuition.
So what do you think you're gonna do?
Right now, I don't know. They're waiting for my response by the end of the night. So I don't know what the fuck I'm gonna do.
Well, how about you call Ma, or Pops, or really anyone, okay? Out with you.
Wow. He might actually go.
Bitch, this isn't the time to cry. You gotta put some fucking war paint on, grab your big girl undies, because this is war on love, motherfucker!
Who's he think he is? What an asshole! What do those stoolie pricks have that we don't? Huh? More money? Better friends? Aren't we enough here? What about me? It's always been Leo and Bo. But now you want to throw everything we built away? Who am I kidding? I didn't even want to go to college in the first place. I just... I just wanted to stick together. I just wanted to be just as good as you, Leo. You're better than me in every way. I just don't know what I'd be without you.
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about, but if you're feeling lonely tonight, I sure could use some loving. What are you, a lefty? Wow. Is that a no?
First. Hey, Leo. I have something to tell you.
Good?
I know that we've been friends for a while.
Yes, tell me what you have to say.
God, I don't think I can do this.
Harper, look at me. Leo is your perfect guy, and he is gonna be off to California where there are a bunch of plastic Barbie bitches. You need to make your move before he falls in love with some chick whose ass is made of 52 plastic bags and looks like a honey handle on Christmas night.
Leo, I like you. I want to be with you.
Good, my young apprentice.
I love it here, but I gotta leave if I want to be anything more than
the one kid who was too afraid to leave town and shoot a shot.
Bowie!
Alright. Sit down, dork.
Bowie, I don't know what to do.
Leo, you know exactly what you got it to. You gotta go be who you were meant to be. You know, you're the kindest, most talented Kai I know, and you were meant for so much more than just being Leo from Leo and Bo.
But Bowie, you guys are everything to me. I mean, I don't know who or what I would be without you guys by my side. I'm not Leo. I'm not anyone without my friends. You're what makes me me.
No, Leo. You are who you want to be. I've always wanted to be just as cool and as smart as you, but I'm not, am I? But if there's one thing that I got from wanting to be you, it was your positive attitude. You make me want to be a better person. You make me want to be who I want to be. And that's all we really need to be, you know? Ourselves.
It seemed like not even a year ago we were arguing about who was gonna buy toilet paper for the next week.
God, this is what real world problems are like.
Thank you, Bo.
No problem.
Hey, dumbass, you done being a piece of shit?
Yeah.
Oh, How you doing?
I'm great. How are you, hot stuff?
Well, I'm a lot better now that Bowie isn't mad at me anymore.
I really am happy for you. So, do you think you're gonna go to Stooley?
Right now? I don't know. I just want to drink and enjoy the rest of this crazy day, so.
Leo, you shouldn't go. Stay here with us. With me. I want to be with you.
Hart, I never knew you felt that way.
Well, I do. And hopefully you feel the same about me, or that would make everything really awkward. Oh, Jesus. I just messed everything up, and now you think I'm weird, and you hate me. Oh, God. Oh, God.
I've loved you since the moment I've met you.
But what about Stooley?
I guess we'll just have to figure it out.
Crystal Pepsi comes in the delicious new flavor of Diet. Available to you, coming soon this Groundhog Day. Now you may be wondering, does Crystal Pepsi cause any bodily harm to you? Any side effects in any way? It does! And so some of these side effects may include, but not limited to, coughing, running nose, itchy throat, hands swelling, poo-poo, extra pee-pee, facial hair on children, an exhausted phallus, your nose may fall off, horny, but without an erection, bleeding eyes, you may become allergic to water and your own organs, loss of toes, your reproductive organs may turn inside out, you may feel the need to consume oil, the pretentious love of bad movies, hair loss, too much sweat, the need to please your own mother, big cheese poop, the horrible luck of having your degree you have been working for the last 3 years to only be taken away by a skinny bag of reverse digestion, itchy eyes, cold chills, headaches, fever, being a complete stupid bitchy asshole with a wife that only likes men half of her own age. Your spine may snap, your pelvic bones may disappear, the ceiling will leak, the floors will creak, there will be a terrible draft, and the walls will ooze green slime, and a loss of appetite. You may be entitled to financial compensation if you feel any of these many effects that may happen, probably, but only maybe. For more details, call 777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777-777- 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7.
Luigi's Italian Restaurant. Stop in today for an extra 5% off our world-famous cannolis. Luigi's Italian Restaurant, where our family is your family.
Luigi's Italian Restaurant. Come in today to get 10% off of our world-famous lasagna. Luigi's Italian Restaurant. When your family's here, we're your family.
I said I merece niente, ti sai adoro.
Luigi's Italian Restaurant. Come in today for 15% off our world famous carbonara. Luigi's Italian Restaurant. Family is home. Home is here. Here's your family.
Luigi's Italian Restaurant. Come in today to get 20% off of our world-famous ravioli. Luigi's Italian Restaurant. When your family's our family, our family's family, family.
It's Luigi's Italian Restaurant. Come in today and get 25% off our world-famous tacos. Luigi's Italian Restaurant. Where the home's family, and your family's home, and Raven's home families. Yep.
Always meant to crash and burn. Maybe if we hadn't taken the chance. Maybe if we hadn't been too quick to trust. Things would be different. But we were foolish.
Diego? Why are you awake? We have to go to space tomorrow.
Go back to sleep, Barada. We always knew this would happen. Love dies. And I will die with it. Thank you.
Did you sleep at all last night?
No.
Why? Did you sleep at all last night?
I don't like sleep. Sleep speeds time. Time is limited. I only have so much left.
You're lucky. It's a beautiful day today. Perfect for space, don't you agree?
No.
No?
I do not want to go to space.
Where is this coming from?
I no longer like traveling to space.
But we always travel to space.
And I always hated it.
Do you even love me anymore? Do you even love me anymore?
I don't like love. Love speeds time. Time is limited. I only have so much left.
Do you even love me anymore? Say to you. I always thought we were made for one another. I would die for you. I would die for you. I will die for you.
Verona, what are you doing?
I can't take this pain.
Yes, you can.
No!
Arata? You are allergic. Please don't do anything you might regret.
Can I take this pain?
You must! Please, you must! I love you, Arata!
I do not like pain.
Pain slows time. Time is forever. I can't live in pain forever.
We were always meant to crash and burn. With her, I felt weightless. Like the whole universe was mine. Ours. I don't know why I dreamt of life without her. I am now alone. I do not like being alone. Being alone. Time have no purpose, and I cannot live without purpose. I was never ready to let my love die, but love dies, and I will die with it.
wall, 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 floor, ceiling, wall, wall, ceiling, wall, wall.
If you're here to get me out of my box, then I don't want to talk to you.
I'll see you in your place to answer some questions.
No?
Then we should be all squared away. May I come in?
I guess.
I'd like to start by asking you something. Tell me, what is so special about this box? Like the room around you, is it not just four walls?
I guess that kind of makes sense.
And would you not say have more room to stretch about out here?
Listen, I need to be able to feel every wall and make sure that they're all really there.
And if they want?
They want to know, or do you?
No, I do.
Good, because I don't want them to know.
Then it will not leave this room.
Don't lie to me. Why would you even keep a secret?
Why would I tell them?
To protect them.
To protect them from what?
Well.
To protect them from whom?
Stop. What's your name?
My name is Christopher.
Your full name?
My name is Christopher Jean-Claude.
Okay. Can you keep a secret?
I will not tell a soul.
Swear to me. Swear on something that you love the most.
I swear on my daughter Christina.
Come close. I have to whisper. Cool.
Not in the box for his protection. He's in the box for ours.
It's not that big of a deal, honey. It happens to everybody.
But it isn't supposed to happen to me. I'm still a young, erect man.
No, you're not.
I like her. She's funny.
Ah! Are you one of the many men like me? Every day, it's been more increasingly difficult to perform for my wife. Every day I try to perform for her with little to no success. The pressures of performing can be intimidating.
Until he found this.
With this, I can finally perform for my wife. I'm as hard as a rock!
Faster, honey!
Thank you.
here to donate one a clothing.
Yeah, sure, okay. All right, Gib. Yeah, I'm sorry, we can't accept this.
Cheese and crackers.
I'm so sorry about this, Waldorf.
Oh, sorry, it was an accident.
Well, it was an accident.
What, was it supposed to be hot water?
Well, I was planning on putting the ice in before you got in the tub. I'm sorry, what was that?
I said you're having too much fun with my pain.
Well, that may be so, but it's not every day that you're the one who gets hurt.
So it's a celebration then?
Not exactly. More like a special occasion.
And a lesson.
A lesson in what exactly?
For you to pay attention when I'm talking to you.
What are you talking about?
I told you last night that the faucet wasn't working. And you know that I make tea on my work mornings.
Okay, it's not my fault you drink leaf water.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Bean Juice. You stay in there.
There's nothing wrong with coffee.
Of course there isn't, dear. Uh-oh.
What is it?
Looks like we're out of painkillers. Oh, I'm so sorry about this, but I really gotta go to work. Are you gonna be okay in here by yourself?
For how long?
I can probably come back on my lunch break with more medicine. No, here. I will put on this audiobook for you, and that way you won't die of boredom.
Yeah, just from hypothermia.
That is not my problem.
It'll build up your pain tolerance. Goodbye. Love you.
I love you too. Spanning stories
where no furry has gone before. Captain Harmonious Curl, the big brown bear, gazed in wonder and pity at the naked, hairless humanoid on. We love your neighbor as yourself by becoming your neighbor.
Yes!
so good to me. Monday morning, it was all I hoped it would be. Oh, Monday morning, Monday morning, couldn't guarantee that Monday evening you would still be here with me.
Postemo, who knows?
He's lost everything.
I've lost everything!
He's got no family. He has a small amount of friends. A modest amount.
What? Oh. Hi.
But now, he's about to have the time of his life. When he's turned into... a cabbage! And he's gonna learn pretty soon that being a cabbage ain't no patch, kids.
Sir, I'm here to tell you that your wife is leaving.
Sorry, buddy. I got to pay. But we can't accommodate your cabbage.
Hey, I'm still walking in, you dumb lady!
Coming this spring, produced by the makers of Corn Man, Corn Boy, and Honey, I've Turned the Children into Cauliflower, comes Cabbage Man, the savage cabbage with baggage, in theaters soon.
Hello?
We got your guy. Meet us at the bridge.
Did you get the ring? Hello? Thank you. So, what happens now?
Everything's taken care of, just like we talked about. Only one thing left to do.
Where's my ring? Shut the fuck up! What's going on? We got your guy.
Come on. Come the fuck on!
Ruby, don't ignore me. This isn't what I asked you to do. I mean, where's my ring? And who the fuck is this? No, wait. No, who the fuck is this? I don't know him.
Francis Allen Walker? You don't look like a Francis.
It's Frankie.
What?
He said it's Frankie. What the fuck's going
Frankie,
on?
Frankie, that's better. Frankie Allen Walker, born September 23rd, 2000, lives at Birchwood Drive, 5'9", 150 pounds, brown eyes, brown hair. You're not even an organ donor?
Fuck
no,
you.
What is he doing here?
Friend of ours heard him bragging about a recent break-in, how much he got off all the loot.
So how do we know he took the ring?
He probably already sold it. He had damn near $3,000
no,
in cash.
No, I don't care
on.
About money, okay? I asked for your help to get my grandfather's ring back. I don't give a fuck about some kid's pocket. I didn't take no god. Look, kid. Being Luke's brother only gets you so fucking far. You came to us about your stupid ring. We came to handle it, and now you want to get a temper? No, I don't care about money. I just want the ring back.
We looked for the ring and pressed him on it. No sign.
You sold it first thing.
No. No, I didn't. Son of a bitch.
Where the fuck is the ring?
I told you already, I didn't take your goddamn ring.
You didn't take it? Hmm?
Please, come on.
Oh, Francis.
Oh, fuck. Oh, I can't fucking do this.
We can't fucking do this. I mean, if he didn't even have the ring on him, how do we even know he took it? He sold it. I said that already. No, no, you said that you heard some kid bragging about stealing, and that he had some money. That's half the fucks in this miserable town.
Listen, you knew what you were getting into when you called us. This might be hard for a little pussy like you, but suck it up. You don't get to have cold feet
now. Okay, okay, just wait. We can't kill this guy if we don't even know he's guilty. That's not how this works.
This is your guy. He had the cash. It all adds up.
But what if it's something? I don't have time for this shit.
No, 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 wait, what the fuck?
I know it's not your grandfather's ring, but it's something.
See ya, kid. Don't come back here. Speaking.
This is the Watson County Sheriff Department. We're calling to inform you we've apprehended a suspect tied to several car burglaries in your area. We have the items you reported stolen. Hello, is
Windermere.
What? honey. How was work?
Usual. Idiot customers who think they know better. Boss couldn't change his tire to save his life.
Well, you'll be home soon.
Yeah. So, what's for dinner?
About that. I've been pretty busy all day, so I forgot to make something. How about we get tacos?
Yeah, all right. No, you got less than a 50% chance of dying if you jump.
You think? Well, why don't you jump and we'll see?
Nah. Don't feel like it today.
Was that all you got?
Yep. Just thought you might want someone with you.
What's your name again?
George.
Well, I tell you what, George. If I die, you can have my change can.
No, it's okay. You keep it. Have fun.
Wait, where are you going?
Getting tacos.
Can I come?
Sure. Hurry up. It's cold.
And my name's Harold, by the way. Thank you for asking.
Good.
These damn bed bugs, I tell you. Whoever named them is a dirty liar.
Put your seatbelt on.
I'll put it on when I am ready.
Again, I'll throw your can out the window.
Hey, sugar. Where are you headed tonight?
Wherever you want, honey.
We're getting tacos.
You two looking for a good time?
No.
I'm sure if you give me the chance, I could show you one.
How old are you?
Does it matter?
Yes.
I'm however old you want me to be.
You should go home.
Hold on. Would you mind giving us just a second, please?
What in the hell are you doing? There is a foxy little filly on the other side of this window, and you're trying to send her home?
It is cold out, and she's just a kid. She should go home.
She is cold, George. Look at her. She probably hasn't eaten yet. Let's take her to get some tacos, and maybe you can take her home after.
Okay.
Great. Scooch over. Hey, Dollface.
How about you come with us and get some tacos and maybe warm up a bit?
All right.
Fantastic!
You can even ride up front.
Thank you.
You're right.
We're at a stop sign, Harold. We have to wait our turn.
So, what's your name, honey?
Lizzie.
Brilliant.
Drive. Please?
Boy, why did you jump in front of a moving car? Ours, specifically.
Well, hello to you, too.
Just answer the question. Why did you jump?
Hi, I'm Lizzie. Are you all right?
I'm perfectly fine. Name's Tucker, by the way.
Nice to meet you. Your tights match mine.
Now hold on just 1 second. Answer the damn question.
Shut up, old man.
We're here.
Why are we at a taco box?
Can I get a chicken quesadilla, please?
I'll get you anything you want, sweet stuff.
Keep it in your pants, boy. George. Looks close.
Yeah.
George, did you get my burrito?
No, I'm a little allergic to tortillas, so could you, like, I usually just
get extra tortilla.
Ooh. That's fine. I'll be
good. This one.
Thank you.
Thank you, George.
Yeah, thank you, George.
Oh my god, George, you gotta pull over.
Shit. George, keep driving. Tucker, stay out of my change point.
Okay, shut up, Harold. Listen, dude, you can't pull over, because then we're going to go to jail.
For what? We didn't do anything. It was all George. He's the one that wanted tacos so damn bad.
Oh my god, I'm too young to die.
If anybody is going to die, it is not going to be me. Everyone, shut up!
No one's going to prison.
Oh, fuck yeah, dude. Step on it. Oh, man.
George?
Oh, man.
You are one crazy motherfucker.
Oh, man. I love you, dude.
Like I said, no one's going to prison tonight. I got mouths to feed.
We should do it again sometime.
Oh. Okay. Hello?
Hey, honey, where are you?
On the road. Got those tacos.
Oh, you didn't get my text? I was asking if you could pick up our pizza. The baby changed its mind.
Yeah.
曾准时，你吃饭了吗？
嗯，吃了。
嗯，这杯给你的。
谢谢。
时间差不多了，我们再等等时间吧。
哦，对了，我有东西要给你。你擦一擦吧，女神留下伤疤就不美了。
谢谢。你抽烟？
嗯，压力大师，你要试试看吗？挺解压的。那我们开始吧。 你先坐这边吧。怎么了吗？
你的头发。
啊，那天有个模特活动，明天就染回去了。你等一下。
So.
我帮你擦药。 要保护好自己。 忍一下，会有点痛。 以后他再这样对你的话，打电话给我知道吗？
原来这世界上还是有人对我好的。
和其他家庭一样快乐。我帮你放回去。还晕吗？没事，就有点晕。 不是喜欢我吗？你不用再装了，我知道你想要的。乖一点。
没力了吧。
当全部人都把你往地狱里推，渐渐的，我不再期待任何人和事，但总有个人，他会带你往反方向走，都费了很大劲往前走，就别回头了。 生命如果没有裂痕，阳光就无法照进来。不是每一段关系的结束都是失去。男人不可靠，我们靠自己。
Yeah.
Wow. And the sandwich, you think?
I really, really think so. It's been eating me alive, gnawing at my insides.
Okay. Dean, this disease is incredibly rare. I mean, you could have every symptom Google has to offer, but that doesn't mean anything.
Something is different. I can't shake the feeling. The feelings.
What you could be going through is a complex psychosis, okay? It's common in situations like this. Situations. Look, there isn't much we can do now. Forensics has me on speed dial, okay? And will let me know if there's any sign of contamination in the evidence or in her, okay? Unfortunately, we can't test you without a very painful procedure called death. Dean, that was a joke. You know, haha.
What?
Look, here's my personal, okay? We'll get in touch with you as soon as we hear something. And don't let it get to your head, all right? Just stay calm. Try and distract yourself.
Did you hear what happened in there? Yeah, real tragedy. Real sad. The young lady living there just lured him in and clean off. Rumor is she ate him too. I don't know about that, but this neighborhood's going to hell, I tell ya. I just hate to be one of the poor bastards that walked into that house.
What?
What? Are you okay?
tonight. Okay, okay, all right. We got a great show planned for you tonight, but before we start, let's meet our contestants. Hi. My name is Dean, and I'm really looking for someone to talk to. Someone who knows what I like and can hold their own in conversation. Oh wow, what a nice guy, right? Okay. Shut the fuck up! All right, let's move on to contestant numero dos.
Hello, beautiful women. Let me show you how much love and passion one man can give.
Ooh, it's gonna be hard to beat that heat, folks. But wait, let's check out contestant number three. Hello? Ooh, tough crowd. How about that special lady, though, everybody?
I think I've made my choice.
The anticipation's eating me alive. That's all the time we have for tonight, folks. But before we go, just remember that special someone is out there waiting for you.
Okay.
Dean. It's been a bit.
Yeah.
A bit. Yeah.
Okay, I think you're cut off tonight, buddy. Can I get you anything? Everything okay?
Surprise me.
Sure thing.
The Missouri Black Widow has been identified as 23-year-old Agatha Martins. She was found dead upon police arrival at the hands of another intended victim. She has been confirmed to 4 murders across the state, but police are investigating a possible 12 more. Her motives are unclear, but all we can do is ask why. Why? Why would she do this to me?
Here you go.
Thanks. What is it?
It's a brain hemorrhage. They're pretty popular this time of year. Is everything cool, or...? Okay, I'll take that as a yes. Want another?
Yes.
This is the water.
Would you keep it down?
I know who you are. I saw your sorry ass on the news.
Okay, it's time for you to go. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here.
Whatever. This place sucks.
What was that all about?
Fuck that guy.
Whoa, hey. It's okay, relax. Have another drink. Wait, Dean.
Hey, asshole. You want another drink? Wait.
Yeah.
Dean, it's Dr. Burkhart.
Oh, hi.
I just want to let you know, forensics have found no trace of the disease, or Kuru, as you put it.
Really? That's good.
As I said, this is an extreme psychosis. I've got you on a list for psychiatric help if you so wish. Now that I've called, these cravings that you talked about should cease for the most part. But still, try to get as much help as you can.
Yeah. Well, thanks, Doc. I really appreciate it.
No problem.